हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल एकता स्किल्स।
फ्रेंड्स, इन एनी लैंग्वेज नो टू वर्ड्स हैव द एग्जैक्टली सेम मीनिंग। किसी भी भाषा में दो शब्दों का बिल्कुल एक अर्थ नहीं होता है। व्हेन ए वर्ड डजंट सूट एट सम प्लेस, देन ए न्यू वर्ड इज डिस्कवर्ड। जब कोई शब्द किसी जगह पर सही नहीं बैठता है तो नए शब्द का आविष्कार होता है। इन दिस वीडियो आई शैल ब्रीफ यू अबाउट वर्ड्स whose meaning appear to be same and are interchangeable in some sentences, but not always. So, let's begin. The first two words that I have selected for you are faith and belief. Faith and belief appear to be same, but they are very different in meaning. They can be interchanged in some sentences, but not in all. Let me cite with an example. A person started to walk on a rope tied between two tall towers at several hundred feet above the ground. He is slowly walking, balancing a long stick in his hand and with his son on his shoulder. Everyone down there was watching him in awe breath and were tensed. He slowly reached the second tower. Everyone clapped, whistled, and welcomed him. They shook hands and took selfies. He asked the crowd, "Do you all believe I can walk back on the same rope now from this side to that side?" The crowd shouted, "Yes, yes, you can do it." "Do you trust me?" he asked. Now this believe and trust. "Do you trust me?" he asked. "Yes, yes, we are ready to bet on you." Everyone supported him. He said, "Okay, if you trust me, can anyone give your child on my shoulder? I will take it to the other side." Now everyone became quiet. There was stunned silence. This is the difference between belief and trust. For trust, you need surrender. We believe in God, but few of us trust Him. The second set of words is contact and connection. A learned saint was delivering his sermon that we are in contact with God, but not in connection. A person asked the saint that he did not understand the difference between contact and connection that the saint mentioned in his discourse. The saint asked the person, "Who all are there in your family?" The person said, "My mother is no more. My father and three siblings. They are all married and stay separate." Then the saint asked, "When did you visit your dad?" The person said, "During Christmas." The saint put a further question, "How many days did you spend with him?" The person replied, 3 days. The saint said, "How much time did you sit together?" The person said, "Some time." The saint asked, "Did you do breakfast, lunch, or dinner with him?" The person replied, "Yes, 1-2 times. The saint said, "Did you ask him how is he spending time after mother's death?" The person's eye became wet. "Did you hug him anytime?" the saint asked. Tears began to flow from the person's eyes. The saint said, "I did not mean to hurt you, but you are just in contact with your father, but not connected. Connection is to sit together, have meals together, to hug each other, to touch and feel each other, and share the sorrow and joy, and to care for each other."
Now the third set is complete and finish.
A group of students asked the teacher, "What is the difference between complete and finish? They sound the same in meaning." I completed my studies. I finished my studies. They have the same meaning. The teacher tried to explain them with example. She asked a girl to step forward. Then she explained the class that every person desires for a good and understanding spouse. Suppose this girl gets an understanding spouse, then her life will be complete. Is it correct? The class agreed. Then the teacher said, if she doesn't get a good and understanding husband, then her life is, all replied in a chorus, finished. So these were the three sets of similar meaning words. I hope you like this video. If yes, subscribe for it, write a comment and give it a big thumbs up. Thanks for watching the video.